And joining us now on Hot Copy as we talk about the impact of a possible tourism blacklist by China, we have Philippine Tour Operators Association President Fe Abling Yu. Good morning to you, ma'am.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen, and good morning to all million viewers.
All right. Well, first, a clarification here. The Chinese embassy has already denied claims that Beijing is planning to blacklist the Philippines because Pogo is in the country. Of course, based on the discussions of Senate President Mick Zubiri with the Chinese ambassador, the Senate president clarified in a text message that it was a warning. And he said that the term blacklist actually came from the good ambassador. There were two witnesses that were in the room. And he says, and I'm reading this verbatim, his message was loud and clear. Pogos are totally illegal in China and those promoting it will be arrested. Their government is asking us to stop hosting Pogo and it could affect tourism potentials if these activities continue. So this is a text message from Senate President Migs Zubiri. He claims that he just relayed the message that was given to him with two witnesses, two other senators in that meeting. The first question I want to ask you, ma'am, is do you believe Pogo is helpful for the tourism industry in the Philippines?
Well, Karen, we have to weigh things, you know. Tourism is very important. Chinese tourists into the Philippines is very, very important. Now, the taxes that is being derived from the Pogo, legal Pogos, are also very important to our economy. So, I mean, both governments, I believe, has to, you know, study very well the impact of this Pogo into our country and also the receipts, the tourism receipts that our country will be benefit from Chinese tourists coming into our country. As you know, prior to pandemic, Chinese tourists is number two arrivals in our country with about 2 million tourist arrivals from their country. And that 2 million, almost 2 million tourist arrivals from China really translate into big employment for our kababayan. You know, every single tourist that comes into our country, regardless of what nationality, really gives a very good employment platform to our people.
Oo. So, ang tanong ko nga, Fe, based on your experience, do you believe Pogo helps in increasing Chinese tourism in the Philippines? Nakakatulong ba ito sa turista o hindi?
Personally, ma'am, hindi po.
Okay, hindi. And what happens because Pogo is banned in China and it's been removed in other ASEAN countries as well just recently. So the question is, although Beijing has clarified that it did not and will not blacklist the Philippines because of this, is do you believe at the end of the day, Pogo is worth it for the Philippines to keep even in terms of tourism revenues?
Well, okay. May kulatilya kasi yung sinabi ng Beijing government.
Mm-mm.
Na kung tatanggalin, di ba, parang iba kasi yung classification ng Pogo as against yung tunay na turista na pumapasok sa atin sa Pilipinas. Di ba? Yung Pogo naman kasi is not translate into tourism. Hindi siya kasi ibang punta nila dito. They are here for employment. Mm-mm. And tourists naman are here para magbigay ng trabaho at ng income sa ating gobyerno. Nagbibigay din naman ang kwan. Pero iba kasi, ma'am, ang implication ng kwan, iba po ang benefit ng turismo sa atin. Oo. Marami pong negosyante talaga ang magkakaroon ng problema kung sakali nga po ipagpapatuloy yung ganong klaseng, if the tourism from China will be, though it was cleared by His Excellency, but again, if it will be pushed through, malaki po ang effect nun sa turismo, sa mga hoteliers, sa mga lahat po ng establishments, even airline companies na pumupunta po dito sa atin coming from China.
Oo.
So, kasi nagpatayo po tayo ng malalaking hotels eh.
Oo.
Ang dami nating hotels na malalaki, not only in Metro and NCR, but also in Boracay or in other parts of the country to cater, of course, all tourists, but largely on Chinese tourism.
Mm-mm. So, Faye, are you saying that we should take into account the concerns of China when it comes to POGO? We should heed their request?
Yes, ma'am. Because kung na po ito eh, this is the call of the Chinese government. They are trying to police their people. We are not the ones who police their people. Concern po nila ito eh. As I keep on reading all the articles that have been released for the past few days, ang lahat po ito boils down sa China na gusto nila pong disiplinahin yung kanilang mga tao. Mm. Kasi for one, sa China po talaga bawal ang lahat ng klase ng sugal, be it whatever, physical or online, whatever. Kasi meron po silang in-identify na isang lugar kung saan ka lang pwedeng magsugal, which is Macau nga po.
Mm.
So kung ang mismo po ang gobyerno ng China ang nagpupulis o dumidisiplina sa kanilang mga tao, sino naman po tayo para kumontra doon?
Okay.
Di ba, ma'am?
Oo. All right. So you've made your point quite clear. So in 2019, I think there were something like 1.8 million Chinese tourists in the country. And considering the population of China, the country's relationship with China, one would think that we could do more. What are the challenges? Because China is at number one, right, when it comes to Asian tourists going to the Philippines. Am I correct to say that it's Koreans?
Yes, ma'am. As of 2019, they are.
Okay. So what can we do better? Why aren't the Chinese our number one tourists?
Well, ma'am, because in my understanding, Chinese coming into the country, Chinese tourists coming into the country are subject, of course, to visa.
Mm. So palagay nyo, dapat tanggalin yon.
Hindi naman po.
Okay.
Huwag naman pong tanggalin nyo. Kasi pag tinanggal nyo po yon, kasi we are also subject to visa going to China.
Okay.
So yun po yung relationship. Huwag naman po sigurong tanggalin yon. Irregularize lang po lahat po ng attached agency na may kinalaman sa pagpasok at paglabas ng sino mang nationality, not necessarily China, dapat lang po regulated.
Mm-mm.
Now, yung nabanggit po ni Senator Gatchalian, yung po tate, we have a very loose border, sinabi niya po yun eh.
Mm-mm.
We have a very loose border na siguro dapat nga yung border natin iayos din lang po para lang po matalagang ma-filter sino po ba talaga yung tamang turista at sino po ba yung hindi tamang turista na pumapasok sa ating bansa.
Okay. Is it difficult for a Chinese tourist to visit the Philippines?
No. No po. Kasi may relationship. We have a very good relationship in terms of tourism po. We have a very good, China and the Philippines have a very good relationship in terms of tourism.
Mm-hmm.
So hindi naman po, as long as the documents are intact, you know, it is arranged by a local tour operator from China,
mm-hmm.
it is well received by a local tour operator in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Ayos naman po yun, ma'am. In fact, kung po sila eh, may mga charter flight pa sila na
okay.
Kung sino yung dumating, sila din po yung uuwi, di ba, ma'am?
Yeah.
So, Accounted po yun, ma'am.
And actually, that's a very good point that you reminded. You talked about the chartered flights and specific flights because prior to COVID, there were flights coming, frankly, from Wuhan that were flying to Cebu. That's correct?
Yes, ma'am. Uh-oh. We have several, chartered flights coming from different parts of China into Boracay and to Cebu. I think there is also for Davao, something like that.
Okay, all right. Now, the latest numbers coming from the Department of Tourism is that Chinese tourists spent a total of $2.3 billion when they visited the Philippines in 2019. So the $2.3 billion is coming from the 1.74 million Chinese tourists who visited. So ang tanong dito, this $2.3 billion that the Chinese tourists had spent, where do they spend it, Ma'am Faye, based on your experience? I mean, they're not. Are the tourists coming here to gamble, or what's the profile of the Chinese tourists?
These are leisure tourists, ma'am. All the way, especially the chartered. They are ibinababa sa either sa Calibo Airport. At they enjoy really our island. You know, they enjoy Boracay. Meron po silang detailed itinerary kung saan sila titira, kung anong kind of activities ang gagawin nila, mag-island hopping ba sila, pati po restaurant, pati po bus, pati po mga tour guides, mga souvenir shops. Detailed po yun, ma'am. So dito talaga yun, kumbaga, yun pong amount na nabanggit ninyo a while ago, talaga pong may tamang pinagpuntahan yun. At yun nga po ang sinasabi ko early in the program na nag-cascade po ito, nag-translate po ito sa employment.
Mm-mm. Okay. Fair, two things I wanted to ask you. Is the number of Chinese tourists, is it affected by our relationship with China on the West Philippine Sea issue? Do you see this as one of the issues why China is at number one in our tourist list?
Hindi naman po siguro, ma'am, because tourism can easily be, though they are interrelated, but I think we have an approach na hindi po namin pinagsasama yung politika as against tourismo. Kasi yung tourismo po talaga, very importante po yan. Sa amin po, I'm speaking as a tour operator in a travel agency, because myself is also sending tourists into China in the same manner that we are also receiving tourists from China. So the exchange of tourists into two countries and between two peoples, talaga po namang pan. Hindi yun, ma'am. I think West Philippine Sea issue is iiwan na lang natin sa ating mga politiko po. Pero tourismo, ito po kami doon. Andun po kami.
And actually, tourism is one tool that can bridge both countries. That's another thing. What are the numbers in terms of Filipinos visiting China? If we had 1.74 million Chinese tourists in the Philippines in 2019, ilan ang Pilipino naman na nagpunta ng China noon?
Wala po ako, to be honest. I don't have exact number as to how many Filipinos visited the touristic places in China, particularly Beijing, Shanghai, and other parts. But then malaki din po, ma'am, malaki din po ang movement ng ating tourist. Kaya nga po ang mga Chinese tour operators, Chinese airlines, panay po ang punta nila dito sa atin to do product update, to showcase to the Filipino people, the tourists, what are the beautiful places that we can see in China, knowing China to be a very historical destination. Yung pong mga loob-loob ng China dyan na hindi talaga nababasa lang natin sa libro, dinadala nila po yun sa atin dito para makita po natin for ourselves kung gaano kaganda po ang China.
Okay.
In the same manner, tayo po pumupunta sa China, nagpa-product update din po tayo kung ano po yung mga emerging destinations na pwede pong puntahan ng mga Chinese people dito sa Philippines, not only Boracay. Marami po kasi tayong mga ganun dapat puntahan.
So, tinanong ko nga sa inyo is if we should heed the call, right? If we should heed the call of China in terms of their concerns with POGO. And do you believe that if we ignore it, I mean, of course, we do have our own concerns as well. The fight for revenue, employment, real estate prices. This has been discussed in the Senate. You had representatives there. But do you believe in the long run it will affect tourism? Kumbaga, we may not see it this year, but in the long run.
Yes, ma'am. As clearly pointed out by the good senator, speaker, good senator,
the Senate president.
Senate president. Yung turismo po talaga, malaki ang magiging effect noon. Kasi marami din naman po ang investment na nangyari para po sa turismo. As I mentioned earlier, marami po tayong ginawang malalaking hotels and everything for them. For housing of these tourists from China, not only from China. But then, yun nga po, yung employment naman, ma'am, na mag-generate sa mga turista na darating galing China, maayos din naman mo yun eh, mag-a-align din po yun. Lahat naman din po mabibigyan ng pagkakataon in the long run na makabalik sa kanya-kanyang trabaho, makakuha po ano man po yung revenue siguro na nakukuha natin sa Pogo. I believe and I strongly believe na makukuha din po natin yun sa turismo. As stated by sir, you know, nag-compute po siya yung 2 or almost 2 million tourist arrivals in 1 year time, spending only $1,000 coming into the Philippines just for 1 year. Ang laki din po ng ipinapasok na receipts. Kaya nga po ang turista, ang tourism, naging malaki din po ang naitulong sa ating ekonomiya. So, tingin ko po, ma'am, kung man tayo po yung panawagan ng China na ayusin yung kanilang internal problem pagdating po sa Pogo, kanila po itong problema na tayo nga po, sabi ko, wala po tayong karapatan siguro, ma'am, na kontrahin yung kanilang panawagan na iayos kung ano man po yung bawal sa kanilang bansa, na kumbaga parang tayo po ay nagtotolerate pa noon kung sakaling ipagpapatuloy natin yung dito sa ating sariling bayan.
All right, on that note, Ma'am Fe Abling, you, thank you for joining me today. I do hope to speak with you again, ma'am, one of these days.
Thank you so much, ma'am, and thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to be heard. Maraming salamat po.